Now, I will explain how to use the standard simplification method in Topos. This method allows constructing underlying nets, which keep the information about the connection of atoms throughout the crystal, and ignore the information about their geometric characteristics and internal structure. To have more information about underlying nets, you should see our webinars on our website sctms.ru. I have the database with structures for which the adjacency matrix was calculated previously. It should be noted that the calculation of the adjacency matrix is the first step in any work with structures in Topos. If you don't know how to do this, please check our previous lesson. Looking at the structure, we can notice that it is rather complicated, and it is difficult to understand how the complexes are connected with each other. To see it, I should construct an underlying net. So we run ADS options, and here we should select a Save Simplified Net option. If you use this option, you should select properly simplification method. For generally, there are 5 different methods. In this lesson, we will use only standard method. For others, see our lessons on our website. When we use standard method, each molecule or ligand will be squeezed to the center of gravity. We press run, and Topos offers to create a new database for the simplified compound. You should use the code 1 to create a new database. Now we should select central atoms. It is a very important stage, because in case of making an incorrect choice of central atoms, the whole analysis will be wrong. The central atoms will not be changed during simplification. Other atoms are considered as a part of ligand and will be squeezed to the gravity center of ligand. In case of having the inorganic compounds or metal complexes, we should select the metal atom as the central one. In this case, metal atoms will keep their positions. Anions or ligands will be squeezed to their gravity center. So, we choose the argentum atom as the central one. For this purpose, we can use this button and choose all metal atoms. It is very useful when you have several different metals. We see the new database created for simplified compounds. We can look at the compounds. There are 3 pseudo atoms here: ZA, ZB, and ZC. We can notice that ZA and ZB correspond to different ligands, ZC to argentum atoms. We can look at the structure. Now, I should determine their topology, but initially I have to delete all 0 or 1 coordinated nodes, while 2 coordinated nodes should be transformed to the edges of the net. This is also a very important stage. You should remember, before classification, you should delete all 0, 1 and 2 coordinated nodes from the net, otherwise you will get a wrong topology. For this purpose, we should use a special procedure. I check compounds, auto-determine, simplify adjacency matrix, remove 0, 1 and 2 coordinated nodes bonded by valence bonds. As you can see, now we have only 4 coordinated nodes. All 0, 1 coordinated nodes were deleted and 2 coordinated nodes were transformed to the edges. Now I can classify the compound. For this purpose, I use ADS, Options, Topology, Classification. Topos informs us that simplification procedure will be turned off because we can use ADS either for simplification or for classification. Then I press Run. Here I should select central atoms again. In this case, central atoms are taken into account during classification. Other atoms are not being considered. We should consider all nodes. Topos informs us that TDD collection that contains information about all topological types is not loaded and offers to load it. For more information about TDD collection and other databases, please see our other lessons. Now we have the topological type of the net. It is a DIA topology. Now we will look how to use the simplification method for molecular piking, having different kinds of bonds. We look at the structure. And, as you can see, there are different types of interactions: hydrogen, specific, and van der Waals. I will analyze the topology of underlying nets constructed for different types of interactions. I select Simplified Net option and check the option Keep Initial Structure to see the initial as well as simplified structure together. Then I go to the tab Topology. Here we should select which bonds will be considered as intra or intermolecular. As you can see, there are 3 positions for each type of bond. If we check the positional atoms, it means that these bonds connect atoms, so they are intramolecular bonds. The position molecular means that these bonds connect molecule, so they are intermolecular. The position none means that these bonds are not taken into account. Now, the valence bonds are intramolecular. Hydrogen bonds are intermolecular and other bonds are not taken into account. We run Topos, then we should select central atoms. In case of the molecular packing, we should check the option whole molecular. In this case, all atoms of molecule will be squeezed to the mass center of molecule. Now I have a database with simplified compound. There are 2 different types of simplified centers here. As you can see, different nodes correspond to different molecules, and the molecules are bonded by hydrogen bonds in the chain. Now I will simplify the structure using hydrogen as well as specific bonds to see how the system of these bonds connects molecules to the crystal. I turn off the option Keep Initial Structure to see only a simplified net. We also have 2 nodes. The net is more complicated. It is not a simple chain, and we will determine its topology. But again, before classification, we should delete 0, 1 and 2 coordinated nodes. I check compounds, auto-determine, simplify adjacency matrix, remove 0, 1 and 2 coordinated nodes bounded by valence bonds. As you can see, now we have only 4 coordinated nodes. We can determine a topology of this net. For this purpose, we use again ADS, Options, Topology, Classification. Now we can see the topological type of net. It has SQL topology. I can use the same procedure for several molecules. We should select compounds, then run ADS. As you can see, in case of selecting several compounds, option Continuous Calculations, which allows calculating several compounds, turns on automatically. I check the Simplified Net option. Then I use valence bonds as intramolecular, hydrogen-specific and van der Waals bonds as intermolecular. Now I have to select central atoms, so I open tab continuous. Here we see element. It means that all atoms in molecules will be considered as the central ones, so the simplification will not be done. We should delete all elements from this line. It means that as central atoms, Topol will consider the whole molecule. Now I will simplify net, and again I should delete all 0, 1 and 2 coordinated nodes to determine the topology properly. I select all compounds and again use compounds, auto-determine, simplify adjacency matrix, remove 0, 1 and 2 coordinated nodes bounded by valence bonds. Now I will determine the topology of these nets. We select all of them, then mark classification option. In this case, in tab continuous, all elements should be marked, because during classification we should consider them all. This option is active by default. Now we can see the topological types of all compounds, the third, the second and the first. So we examined the standard simplification of packing. For other ways of simplification, please see our other lessons.